all come into the open area where they were lying earlier on. And I wonder if perhaps the rest of the pride hadn't actually been coming from wherever it is that they were left this morning. And then what we saw was their greeting, their fantastic, very powerful greeting after not seeing each other for a few hours. That was a very special moment we just witnessed, and I think they're all exhausted of after such excitement. Tom, you're saying that you're surprised at how something so ferocious can always be so loving. Well, all animals have a vulnerable side of them, and social relationships are incredibly important for lions. I mean, they are the only sociable cat. So making sure that they greet each other the proper way when they find each other is a way of keeping good relationships and just making sure that everything is fine and that they catch up with each other. So I think they actually, the other ones weren't here. I think they just kept coming, and the female, one of the females picked it up. Perhaps she actually even heard the contact call from one of the other females when we heard her answer. And then they all moved off towards where they were. They all found each other, greeted each other, and came and lie down pretty much in the same spot where we had them earlier on. But look at that. Look at all those pretty ears amongst all the round-leaf teaks. Oh. There was something like sounded like maybe like a bush bug or a nyala in the distance in the drainage line. So I think these guys are definitely out and about. And this is the time of the life for the cubs when they're going to start walking with the pride. And often if their mothers go hunting, then they leave them behind because they're still a bit young. But this is a crucial time in their lives when they're going to start developing the skills to hunt together. Interesting. Last time I saw the Nkuhumas, they were so sleepy, they barely even woke up. And today, they've provided already so much excitement from the tracking, from the they were not there, to carried on moving and greeting each other, and now coming back and laying down here. Beard, you're saying that we witnessed a family reunion. We certainly did, and I think it was a very special one. It's always wonderful to see how excited lions are to come across the rest of their pride members. Just jump on top of each other and say hello and head rubbing, and it's almost like people are trying to, well, lions are trying to get into other lions' hugs. It's amazing. Shem, I think these cubs, although these paws are meant for walking, these little cubs have been walking quite a lot, and I think they are definitely tired because the females are still somewhat alert with their heads sticking up, most of them, but the cubs are very, very sleepy. Yeah, you guys have been walking a lot because you have been going with the pride. Aquarius, you're wondering if a male lion showed up here, how would all the lions react? Well, if it's a male that they know, they would react somewhat in the same manner that they did now. There would be some head rubbing, and very likely all of the females would be very alert before the male approached, just to make sure that it's a known male lion. Now, if it wasn't a known male lion, then there would be a lot of aggression, because foreign or male lions that do not associate with his pride are a major threat to the cubs, because often, even if the cubs look big enough, they are still very young and vulnerable and can be easily killed by a male that's coming onto the area. So, like I said, if it were a male lion that's not known to the pride, likely they would be quite aggressive, and the cubs would probably run away and just seek shelter away from the male. My heart is so full. Doodles, you're wondering if the big cubs will still try to nurse. Well, we saw them try, but I think it's more comfort nursing than anything else. Normally, lions are weaned around about 6 months old, and these guys are older than that, so I'm not too sure why they're being the way that they are, but they are onto meat. Their mothers at this age cannot sustain them on milk, so that's why they introduce them. And even roughly, let's say 6 to 8 weeks old normally, no, actually a little bit older in lions, maybe at 3 months old, they start introducing them to meat. So they will still nurse and have some of the milk, but they will also start eating meat. So as you can imagine, little lions have to grow very fast, and the more protein they get, the better for them. Who knows, maybe this is a new spot where they're gonna spend the night. It seems like they are pretty settled now. Maybe the three females were a bit wary. I reckon perhaps they went off trying to look for food and they didn't find anything, and the rest of the pride has caught up to them. And now that they're all together, it seems like they are all a lot more relaxed than what they were before and all sleeping. Izzy, you're wondering why the lions don't get names like the leopards do. Well, because they are sociable animals, and it can be sometimes harder to identify a lioness from the next one unless they have some very bright or very key identifying feature. So it's a lot easier just to try and identify them as a pride, because in more cases than not, the pride will be together. So that's why they get collective name, like the Nkuhuma Pride of Lions, which is these females here. So we know that at the moment it's five females and six cubs. There is one of them or two amongst them. One of them is clearly amber eyes, because she's got this beautifully striking amber eyes, so she's easy to distinguish from the rest. And then there's the one that's got a problem in her right eye. Seems like she doesn't have all that good vision in there, if perhaps she does have any. So you can still identify individual lions, individual females, just by looking at their spot pattern on top of their whiskers. However, I think it's just slightly easier to identify them as a pride, because chances are that when you find them, they'll all be together. And because they are territorial creatures, they stick around the same area. Aquarius, you're wondering who comes up with all these names. Well, normally their names are given... That's beautiful. Oh, you're so gorgeous. Normally the names are given by some sort of characteristic area or name of an area or part of the area where they are in most cases. So the names either come from a drainage line or from a special characteristic that they've got, or I'm trying to think of anything else where they would name a pride of lions. I would say in most cases it's a geographic name. Guys, how exciting. Now everybody's wasted all their energy and walking today, and now we're all back down, aren't we? Now I wonder if perhaps there will be a male coming, because earlier on I was saying that there was one female that was missing that was seen with the two males, and then they've managed to find one male and then said that the other male and the female had carried on walking south. They didn't say that they had crossed the boundary, so I wonder if perhaps one of the Birmingham boys might be somewhere in the block. That'll be quite interesting to find out. I think maybe your lion plot thickens, because there were definitely two this morning with one of these females. Now we've got all the females here, but no males. So I wonder if perhaps the male just decided he didn't really want to come and see the rest of the pride and he's sticking out somewhere else. Perhaps further north where we started looking, perhaps in that area. So I think maybe it's worth keeping an ear out. Maybe we'll hear them roaring later today. And then we'll be able to find out if there's a male around or not. Because as we were saying a few days ago, a Birmingham lion has been a rare sight lately. Luckily the girls are here.